Hello students, today we are going to have a discussion on the chapter Fight Manju Fight, written by Sigrun Srivastava and taken from your textbook English Literature. First of all, let's have an introduction to the chapter. Let's begin. Obstacles come in everyone's life. Some are disheartened by these obstacles, while others there are who get greater strength from them. Fight Manju Fight is the story of young girl Manju. He belongs to the latter type. Difficulties come in her life, but she does not surrender before them. She accepts these difficulties as a challenge of life. She suffers from the deformities of hands and feet. She wants to become a painter, though not as great a painter as M.F. Hussain. Besides these physical problems, she has financial problems also. But she fights against these odds till she emerges as a winner. When she takes a firm decision to fight against odds, others come to help her. In spite of monetary problems and her father's apathy, that is disinterest, she, that is Manjula, develops her painting skills. Now let's have a discussion on some crucial elements of the chapter. Let's explore some crucial points, salient features of the chapter. First of all, Manju Paralkar's deformity of hands and feet. Manju has deformed hands, claw-like fingers and clumsy malformed feet. Her hands always exposed but feet covered in ugly made-to-order suits. She is fond of painting. In spite of her deformity, Manju could handle brushes. Her real problem was high cost of painting material. Mother is considerate and helps by giving money from her savings to buy colors and paints. First painting admired means the first painting of Manju was appreciated by others. Okay, so first painting admired. First watercolor painting admired by parents. Mother considers it perfect. Another concern in the chapter is Manju's birthday presents. On her 13th birthday, that is on 13th birthday of Manju, mother gives a set of watercolor to her, that is to Manju. Father presents a book on painting. Painting Step by Step is the name of the book. The name of the book was Painting Step by Step, and it was presented by father. Her brother presented her a big packet. Her brother gives a big packet to her. Manju opens with difficulty the packet. The packet is opened by Manju with difficulty. In the packet, three bruises were found under a pillow. What was there in the packet offered, presented by her brother Amol? These were three bruises and were kept under a pillow. Now we further learn from the lesson, Manju's demand for watercolor papers of good quality. Manju's demand for watercolor papers of good quality. Now, mother is ready for it. Father's consent must be taken. Although mother is ready, but father's consent was still unknown or they were unaware of. So mother is ready for it. Father's consent must be taken. We are talking about Manju's demand for watercolor papers of good quality. Mother is ready for it. Father's consent must be taken. Father is reluctant. That is showing hardly any interest. Father is reluctant. That is disinterested. Talks about his other liabilities. And father talks about his other liabilities like management of household and so many things. He explains or he puts his point of views that a sari to be bought for Manju's mother and he was unable to buy because of financial crisis or monetary crisis. Mother is considerate and she is ready to give it up. Means she is ready to sacrifice her sari. Father talks about high cost of living and increasing expenditure. He wants Manju to learn cooking or stitching instead of painting. Now we further explore in the lesson. Manju overhears conversation of father and mother. Manju overhears conversation of father and mother. By having overheard the conversation, Manju is so upset that she tears her panties. Manju is so upset after overhearing the conversation of her father and mother, she tears her panties. She puts her brushes and colors in a corner of the cupboard. Manju offers to learn cooking from her mother. Brother Amol gives encouragement. What do you find later in the chapter? That Brother Amol gives encouragement. He asks Manju to participate in on-the-spot painting competition. Amol is confident if Manju participates, will win first prize. Father was unhappy. He was going to Bombay for a meeting at Taj Hotel. Manju too was desirous to go to Bombay. Manju too was interested to go to Bombay. Art college was there in Bombay. There was an art college in Bombay and that was attracting the attention of Manju. So she wanted to accompany her father to Bombay. Now we have further ideas from the chapter. Manju discouraged by father's attitude. Manju was discouraged by father's attitude. Mother encourages her to develop willpower and not to be afraid of difficulties. Mother encourages Manju to develop a strong willpower and not to be afraid of difficulties. Manju was upset, unconvinced, goes to her room. Now further we come to learn that a newspaper cutting was lying on the table. Manju surprised to read it. It was inscribed that it was written playing soccer with artificial feet. That is playing football with artificial feet. Playing soccer with artificial feet was the headline in the news clipping. That is whatever was written on the cutting, on the newspaper cutting. When Manju read it, she was surprised, and it was written playing soccer with artificial feet. The article was about Rhys Ballinger, who had lost his feet in an accident, in a train accident. Further, Manju feels encouraged, decides to fight. After having learned about Rhys Ballinger and his brave-heartedness, she was inspired and encouraged. She was inspired and encouraged and decides to fight the circumstances, odd circumstances. Manju feels encouraged by having learned the story of Rhys Ballinger, and she decides to fight the odds. Odds means difficulties or difficult situations. Now further we have Manju takes out brushes and colors from cupboard. Later in the story, we come to know that the day of competition, on the day of competition, Amol goes to school simply to participate in making arrangements. On the day of competition, Amol goes to school to help others in making arrangements for the competition. Manju declares that she would participate. She talks about Rhys Ballinger and decides not to give in. That is, she will not lose her heart. Okay. If Rhys Ballinger could do it, she pressed that if Rhys Ballinger could do it, why can't Manjula Parilkar? Now let's talk about the theme. The theme of this chapter is that obstacles come in everyone's life, but they should not discourage us. If one has a strong willpower and firm determination, difficulties give way. Hurdles do not dishearten a man of firm will. Rather, they give him greater strength. One should resolve sincerely, and sooner or later, success will surely come his way. Now talk about the title. Fight Manju Fight is the story of a young girl, Manjula Parilkar, who, in spite of her malformed fingers, does paintings and wins appreciation. She is a talented girl. She has to fight against adverse circumstances. Her father, who is financially not well off, finds it difficult to bear the expenditure of costly painting material. But her mother loves her and continues to boost her morale. Amol, Manju's brother, also encourages her. But the final moral boosting comes from Rhys Ballinger, who plays soccer with artificial feet. Artificial means human-made, man-made feet. Her mother, Amol, and Rhys Ballinger all seem to be urging her to fight and fight. Her mother, Amol, and Rhys Ballinger all seem to be urging her to fight and fight against the odds, against the adverse conditions. She must paint and paint, she thought. Thus, the title, Fight Manju Fight, is very suitable for the story. Now, let's talk about the characters in the story. Manjula Parilkar. Claw-like fingers and deformed feet. Manjula is a young girl of 13. She has claw-like malformed fingers and deformed feet. Her feet can be hidden in ugly, made-to-order shoes, but nothing can be done about her hands. She feels pained and miserable due to these deformed hands, and she suffers from a feeling of inferiority. But she has a positive attitude towards life. Positive, optimistic attitude. Manju is optimistic. In spite of her deformity of hands, she knows that she can paint well. She is a sensitive girl. Manju is very sensitive. Once she overhears the conversation of her father and mother, her father is complaining about the costly painting materials. She feels so upset that she gives up the idea of painting. She even puts her brushes and colors aside. Her mother encourages her and asks her to fight. Her brother, with the example of Rich Pelangar, asks her to struggle. No wonder she decides to fight and fight, paint and paint. Another character that we do have in the story, Manjula's mother. Typical middle class woman devoted to family. Mrs. Parilkar is a typical middle class woman, an affectionate mother and a devoted housewife. She is completely attached to her household duties. Realizing that Manju has deformed hands and feet, she has a special corner for her. Affectionate and caring mother. When Manju expresses a desire to buy colors and paints to learn painting, she gives her money from her sacred savings. Sacrificing nature. When her husband talks about his financial liabilities, including a sari to be purchased for her, she readily sacrifices it to buy painting materials for Manju. When Manju says that she likes to learn cooking, her mother understands that she is saying it unwillingly. Urges Manju to fight. Mother urges Manju to fight. She says with firm determination, "Don't give in. Don't give in." Means don't lose heart. Don't give in. Fight, Manju, fight. Thus, she encourages her daughter and helps her to be optimistic. Now we have Manjula's father in the story. He is an economical and practical person. Mr. Parilkar, Manju's father, is a typical middle class man, economical, practical and down to earth. He has modest means and likes to live within his means. He appreciates Manju's painting, but he feels that it is a costly hobby, and with modest means, he can't afford the painting material. He wants that Manju should learn cooking or stitching. A loving and caring father. Manju's father is a loving and caring father. Mr. Parilkar is a loving father. On 13th birthday of Manju, he gives her a book as her birthday present. It is, the name of the book is Painting Step by Step. What else about Manjula's father? He is a dutiful husband. Mr. Parilkar is not only a caring father but also a dutiful husband. He is aware of his duties. He is aware of his duties and the rising prices. He knows that his wife needs a new sari, his son Amol needs a pair of shoes, and the curtains need a change. As head of the family, he must do these things. He must do these things. Now we have another character in the story, Amol, the brother of Manjula Parilkar. Amol is the brother of Manjula Parilkar in the story. Let's talk about the traits of Amol. He is having childlike nature, innocent mischiefs. Amol is a mischievous lad of 12. Although he loves Manju, yet he is ever ready to tease her. On her 13th birthday, he presents her a big parcel tied with knots. Knots. That is gaunt. On her 13th birthday, he presents her a big parcel tied with knots. He knows that Manju, with her malformed fingers, would find it difficult to open. Further, he loves Manju. When Manju manages to open all the knots, she finds a slip of paper inside. She fears what it would mean. The slip reads, "Look for the next clue under your pillow." Under the pillow, she finds 3 bruises of excellent quality. Further, he encourages her indirectly. Amol appreciates the talent of Manju and wants that she should rise high in the field of painting. Amol appreciates the talent of his sister Manju and wants that her sister, that is Manju, should rise high in the field of painting. He indirectly encourages her to participate in on-the-spot painting competition. It is he who keeps the newspaper cutting on the table near Manju's bed. Thus he endears himself to her.